Hi, I'm Whitney Morgan, Hashimoto's coach, gluten-free warrior, and creator of the Gluten Gauntlet System and the Thyroid Reboot Method. Of all the symptoms that my clients with hypothyroidism complain about, weight gain is probably at the top of the list. In this video, I'm going to explain one of the reasons why hypothyroidism and weight gain go hand in hand and what you can do to break the vicious cycle. But before we jump into it, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and the little bell next to it so you'll be notified every time I drop a new video. I've worked with dozens of women struggling to lose the weight that they have gained due to an underactive thyroid. And a couple of things they have in common are uncontrollable food cravings and a complete inability to shed the pounds no matter how hard they try. Beginning to break this vicious cycle is part of step one of my thyroid reboot method. Let's take a moment to talk about what's driving this vicious cycle in the first place, and that is a hormone called leptin. Leptin is a hormone that's produced by your fat cells, and it sends signals to your brain, telling your brain when you've had enough to eat. So how quickly you feel full and how satisfied you feel by a meal depends a great deal upon this hormone. Leptin oversees all of your energy stores, and it plays a dominant role in whether or not you store fat or you burn it. Now, you probably already know that when you have an underactive thyroid, your metabolism slows down, and it encourages your body to store fat instead of burning it. So your hypothyroidism is that first domino to fall that puts you on the path to gaining weight. But as fat cells increase, so do leptin levels. And when there's too much leptin floating around in the bloodstream, it encourages the cell receptors for leptin to shut down, and you develop what's called leptin resistance. When leptin can't get into the cells because you've got leptin resistance, your brain stops getting the messages that you're full. And because the brain isn't getting this message, it assumes that nutrients are scarce, and it puts your body into a type of starvation mode. Your metabolism slows down even more, and energy expenditures decrease. Your cravings go up, your body stores more fat, and you keep gaining weight. And if that's not enough, as leptin resistance increases, your T3 levels decrease, and your thyroid function is worse off than it was before. And now we've got a vicious cycle that just keeps going round and round, and you can't lose the weight. Are you struggling with weight gain and cravings no matter what you do? If so, give me an eye roll emoji in the comments. If you want to start breaking this vicious cycle, you have to improve your leptin sensitivity. So you have to get those leptin receptors to start working again. Fortunately, there's a few easy steps that you can take right now to help you do this. First, you gotta get 8 hours of sleep every night, and it's best to get to bed by 10:30 p.m. Second, you need to get a moderate amount of exercise every day. But a word of caution here, don't overexercise. Overexercising will actually increase leptin resistance, and you don't want that. A third thing you can do is to reduce your carbohydrate intake overall, and it's a good idea to watch your intake of fructose. So keep your fruit intake low, like a small amount of berries on a daily basis, and that's it. And absolutely stay away from high fructose corn syrup. That will make that leptin resistance worse. In my opinion, eating according to a paleo or a primal template is the perfect diet to follow to improve leptin sensitivity. Another thing to focus on is trying to reduce your stress levels. And for those things that you can't control, make sure you're doing something on a daily basis to help manage your stress. Whether it's meditation, tapping, journaling, or deep breathing, just make sure you do something every day to keep your nervous system balanced. And finally, you need to ditch the unhealthy fats. So eliminate all trans fats and industrial seed oils from your diet. And while you're at it, increase your intake of fatty fish or of omega-3 fatty acids. The silver lining to all of these suggestions that will help improve leptin sensitivity is that they also help you improve basic thyroid function. To learn more about my thyroid reboot method and how to improve thyroid function from the ground up, click on the link in the video notes. If you're watching the replay on Instagram, just head to my bio link. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, you can let me know by liking it, subscribing to my channel, or sharing this video with a friend who has thyroid issues and is struggling with weight loss. And as always, if you have questions, just leave them in the comments. I really do my best to answer each and every one. I'll see you next week.